Our last way of solving quadratic equations is using the quadratic formula. The quadratic formula works for all quadratic equations. You can factor them, you can still work them by quadratic formula. Mostly it's used if you can't factor a quadratic equation, if it's prime. It's really just plug and chug. That's it. You pick out your A, your B, your C terms and plug them in and then solve. So your arithmetic might be a little touchy, but there are just four little steps to it. First, you have to make sure your equation's equal to zero. Assign values to A, B, and C. Fill the values into your formula and solve for X. You can do the little song to Pop Goes the Weasel. That's what I sing in class because actually that is easy to remember and everybody can do it. X equals the opposite of B plus or minus square root B squared minus 4AC all over 2A. I know you can't believe I'm singing that on video, but I don't care. I just want you to learn it, and a catchy tune will help you learn it. So try that over and over, and that's what I do in class. So you'll be asking me to stop it Monday. Anyway, so you have to learn it. You will not have the formula on a test. A is always the coefficient of your x squared term. B is always the coefficient of your x to the first power. C is always the constant. So then you just plug and chug. X equal the opposite of B, which is a negative 2, plus or minus square root B squared minus 4AC all over 2A. And then it's just arithmetic. So the opposite of a negative is a positive, plus or minus B squared or anything squared is positive. And then this is the catchy part. You have a negative times a positive times a negative. So all of this would be a positive 4. That's tricky sometimes. People get their signs confused. 2 plus or minus square root of 8 over 2. And this we talked about simplifying radicals when we extracted square roots. So you can't leave it as square root of 8. That's the same thing as 4 times 2. And the square root of 4 is 2. And leave the solo guy in there. Now, this is the answer, but you could go one more because this is the same thing as both terms or each term over 2. So 1 plus or minus square root of 2 would be actually the answer that I would prefer. So you can see we just chose our A, B, and C, or assigned them actually, and then filled it in. So if we do it one more time, A would be the x squared term. B would be negative 4. C is negative 5. Let's fill it in. X equal the opposite of B plus or minus square root B squared minus 4AC all over 2A. We have positive 4 plus or minus the square root of 16 plus positive 20 times 2 is 40 over 4. 4 plus or minus square root of 56 all over 4. And you need to come over here and simplify that. So let's see. 56 is the same thing as 7 times 8. So 7 times 2 times 2 times 2. That one pair, so it'll pop out 2 square root of 14. So we have 4 plus or minus 2 square root of 14 all over 4. You can leave it there or drop it down. Preferably just drop it down one more time. 4 over 4 is 1. 2 goes into 4, or this divides out and will simplify into square root of 14 over 2. And we can talk more about this in class. I would love for you to do this one on your own and bring it to class, but if you notice, it is not set equal to 0. So you'll need to do that. Use addition property and add 7x, so you'll have 0 on one side of the equal sign. 4x squared plus 7x minus 1. Now you've got a quadratic equation that's set equal to 0. A is 4, B is 7, and C is negative 1. Now work it using quadratic formula and bring me the answer in class and let's see how you did.